questions? What are your issues? I'm happy to answer any thought and question as long as it's a genuine attempt to understand rather than just sort of like a rhetorical question and a speech. Yeah, what's your name?
My name's Omar.
Okay.
So you mentioned a lot of things in the speech, and you said you want us to understand each other. I'm Egyptian Muslim.
Okay.
And so there's a few things. I understand, to be honest, the Jews being sensitive about often feeling that their Israel, let's say, is being singled out for criticism and etc.
I want to question so we could get as many as possible. You're a student here, so I'm hoping people are going to come to you afterwards. Let's have the question, if you could.
Sure,
if you could give me a question.
Let's have reciprocity.
I have your questions not in an hour because I've been talking for an hour.
Okay.
Question.
Fine. In this case, you should let somebody speak because you said a lot of claims, so that's
what
I addressed them.
I just wanted a question and then I'm happy to answer it. What's your question?
Okay, fine. Well, you said many things. Okay. You said, first of all, that look at the areas. If we start with the map. Okay, so if we start with the map, what are the conditions of the peace treaty, peace deal that you mentioned? You presented a supposed neutrality, but there's nothing neutral in what you said, okay? Because this map, okay, so Israel will have to control the borders in this plan. Israel controls the borders. The Palestinians aren't allowed an army. The Palestinians aren't allowed any type of sovereignty. You presented an image of neutrality, showed us a video of Israeli Palestinian rockets getting fired at an Israeli shelter, but you don't show us a video of an Israeli airstrike in Gaza.
So
you say you respect international law, you say you respect human rights watch and Amnesty International all condemn Israel.
So what's your question?
How does Israel respect international law when Human Rights Watch, when the UN, Israel has had the most UN resolutions than any other country in the world?
If you want it to be fair, let's debate the points.
Okay?
Statistically,
how many Israelis were killed in the last few wars?
You want me to answer your question or
yes.
not?
How many Israelis
so there are two questions. There are two questions you're asking. First of all, I understand why you're angry, and I can understand why you're frustrated. And that's okay.
Really?
Of course I am.
Not frustrated because you spoke for hours and you weren't able to tolerate 2 minutes. That's why.
From someone who's interested in dialogue, you're not very good at listening either.
Would you like
me to answer your question?
Okay, go ahead.
Are you sure?
Go ahead.
So number one is, anyone who's angry, anyone who's frustrated, anyone who's etc. I get it. I totally get it. If you're saying you're coming from Egypt, I get it even more. There's a very close friend of mine was tortured under President Sisi and managed to escape. So I'm very aware of some of the suffering which is going on in Egypt as far as the Egyptian regime is concerned. Somewhat slightly ironic when Israel is being criticized from a regime which the people, as you know itself, in Egypt are trying to deal with President Sisi, who came in on a military dictatorship. That's number one.
Yeah, I was shocked at Sisi.
Right, exactly. So I can understand your anger.
Okay.
Second of all is this. Look, there's two different issues. Issue number one is, when you talk about the United Nations and etc., we can go back and forth, all right? I can say at the end of the day is, look, the United Nations is a farce. If you really want to quote the United Nations, you want someone to understand why no one takes the United Nations seriously, ask someone from Rwanda. Because the United Nations stood as their people were massacred. Okay? So you'll excuse me if the United Nations, who has Syria on its Human Rights Council, I don't take too seriously. Who has Saudi Arabia on its Women's Rights Council, I don't take too seriously.
Human Rights Watch, Amnesty International.
So again, the fact that Amnesty International and Human Rights Watch is critical, in my humble opinion, and I'm only one short fabric Jew, is that's good. Why? Because it enables and it shows that Israel is being accountable, right? You know the difference between here and Egypt? I don't have to tell you. You can yell and shout in Egypt, and the next day, you're going to be arrested, all right? Now, when you look on the Israeli side, no one's saying everything is right. The opposite. What we're saying is, you can continue to be angry, which I get, and frustrated, which I get, and you can continue to say, continue the slogans, all right? But the reality is, at the end of the day, how do you get somewhere? What's your solution? What's your solution? And like, if you dismiss, well, I understand how the Israelis are insecure, but that's part of it. All right. So I apologize if I cut you off because I just want a wider discussion. But the real issues are, how do you get to Israelis and Palestinians and even Egyptians, not yelling and shouting and like, yeah, but rather actually sitting back down at the negotiating table? The biggest tragedy I see is that no one's at the negotiating table. The issue of arms, at the beginning of Oslo, Israel allowed the Palestinian police to have arms as to control.